What do you guys think is the biggest video game franchise of all time? Call of Duty? Halo? Street Fighter? Sonic? Well, today we're going to be talking about the top 10 highest grossing and biggest video game franchises of all time. And some of these picks might surprise you guys, where games like Minecraft didn't make as much as you thought, and other games like Fortnite that have been really huge pale in comparison when you look at decade-long franchises that have been around forever. And let me know what you guys think of this video as well, as I'm still trying to figure out exactly what I want to put on my YouTube channel along with more in-depth gaming commentary. So leave a comment down below, leave a like if you like the video, and I am Frank. Sugar shine, damn, I'ma go. It's crazy this life, but I know I love it. And I know I'm me, I know I'ma go, ain't nothing above it. And this for the deal, my people that's going through. I tell you this, for when my days have come to an end, you shall be king. Coming in at number 10 on our list is a franchise most of you probably know, and that's Warcraft. Originally coming out as Blizzard's first delve into the RTS genre, Warcraft Orcs and Humans released in 1994 and was instantly a big success for Blizzard, and eventually led them to creating more franchises that we all know and love, like StarCraft. But Warcraft is more than just the RTS side. Warcraft also includes things like card games, including Hearthstone, and the game you are all probably thinking of and where most of the vast majority of their gross income has come from, World of Warcraft. World of Warcraft released in November of 2004, but its peak subscribership was actually during its Wrath of the Lich King era, in around 2006-07, and then they had upwards of 5.5 to 6 million subs, which means they were bringing in close to $400 million per year just off of World of Warcraft, and that doesn't include any sales of merch, other games, and just IP property as a whole. Blizzard hit a gold mine with the Warcraft series, and they will for sure be continuing to push more and more content in whatever style of games that is in the future, as well as continuing to support World of Warcraft, as it is by far their biggest cash cow. Next on the list, we have a game that is quite popular in both the Western Hemisphere and the Eastern Hemisphere, and that's Final Fantasy. The original Final Fantasy RPG game came out in 1987, and this long-standing series has had over multiple decades worth of games coming out now, with multiple games in the RPG series stretching all the way to 16 now, as well as remasters coming out recently for Final Fantasy VII. But one of their biggest cash cows is a game that doesn't get talked about as much until recently, and that's Final Fantasy Online. Final Fantasy's newest MMO is actually a huge cash cow for the company, just as World of Warcraft is for Blizzard, and they've found a lot of success, especially recently, with great reviews and a lot of people exclaiming that this is the best MMO on the market, even surpassing World of Warcraft. And it looks like Final Fantasy isn't gonna go anywhere anytime soon and continues to grow year over year. At number 8, we have a series that is also beloved across the world, and that's Street Fighter. I didn't realize Street Fighter was so popular, but the more I've looked into it, it makes sense. Originating in 1987, the same year as Final Fantasy, Street Fighter is one of the premier fighting games that has really been in the hearts of fighting game fans for decades now. Now, on its fifth iteration, Street Fighter 1 through 5 has had its ups and downs, but throughout the entire time, it has been a mainstay at fighting game tournaments across the world. On top of this, Street Fighter has been able to garner a lot of extra gross income because of selling their IP rights to other institutions. For instance, Street Fighter was all across the world during the arcade boom, and they made a lot of money through this, and they tend to have a lot of crossovers, like Capcom X Street Fighter and Street Fighter X Tekken, and these projects all make them a lot of money, and they seem to have their hands in every aspect of the fighting genre for the past 30 years now.
Is that all, child?
Coming in at the number 7 spot, we have Dungeon Fighter Online. What the fuck is this? So, I actually didn't know what Dungeon Fighter Online was before doing my research, but upon further inspection, this is one of the biggest game franchises in the world. Originating from Nexon out of South Korea, Dungeon Fighter Online is a beat-em-up brawler MMO. And while the franchise isn't very popular in Western culture, it has over 600 million players in South Korea, China, and overall across the Eastern continents that are die-hard fans of this franchise that has been around only since 2005. Which is one of the newest franchises on our list and makes the impressive amount of money it's made all that more outstanding.
Go back to basics with a black and white television set, and cleverly, pieces of color gels create the red illusion at the top and the blue at the bottom. But you know what they did? Midway put behind this glass, this is actually plexiglass, some games had glass,
Now guys, for number 6 on our list, we have a little bit of a throwback to a game that inspired gamers across the world to first get into the medium in 1978, and that's Space Invaders. I wasn't expecting Space Invaders to have such a huge gross income, but if you really think about it, it makes sense. Space Invaders is one of the defining video games of a generation, and it has continued to live through in multiple iterations even to this day, with more and new Space Invader-like games with the property coming out on Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS4, and even Steam. And Space Invaders continues to keep its reign even decades after its first release, and it's a game that, quite honestly, is iconic across the gaming landscape, and there's not much else like it, except for our next game.
3,333,360. Ooh, it's exhausting to just say it. I began in a competitive world of pinball. It moved to Donkey Kong. But the greatest level of competition at the moment was Pac-Man.
For the halfway point on our list, we once again turn back to another retro game, and one that has even more name recognition than Space Invaders. And that's Pac-Man. Pac-Man, the game that almost everyone on planet Earth has at least played once, is a household name across the entire world. And everyone knows about that yellow man chomping his way, running away from ghosts, and trying to beat every single level. Pac-Man originally came out in 1980. Just after Space Invaders, but in that time, it has narrowly squeezed ahead of its predecessor and really taken the retro gaming scene by storm. The majority of Pac-Man's money, which was made by Bandai Namco, came from selling the rights to different arcade agencies, and they made a killing back in the 1980s and 90s and are continuing to still make a decent amount of income even to this day off the Pac-Man rights.
You can see right here, I'm getting ready to serve. All I do is throw that ball up in the air, and when I... Oh, jeez! And there goes the tennis racket.
And now, for number 4 on our list, and our newest franchise in our list series, is actually Wii Branded Games. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, that refers to games like Wii Sports and Wii Fitness and any of the games that had Wii branding on the Wii platform when it first released. Even though the Wii originally released in 2006, in that short amount of time, all of the Wii branded games have astonishingly made a massive amount of money and blown past other franchises that came out in the 70s and 80s. And it makes sense, as the Wii was one of the most popular game consoles of all time, and it seemed like every single mom, dad, and kid had one. And if you had a Wii, you had to have either Wii Sports, Wii Fitness, Wii Tennis, or one of the original Wii branded games that came with the system. And while a lot of the success of these games can be attributed to the success of the console itself, it still is crazy to see just how much money in such a short amount of time these game franchises managed to make. And now, guys, we are to the top three gaming franchises of all time. The franchises that have managed to pull in more money than any other franchise in the world. These brands command respect, they command dignity, and regardless of whether or not you actually like these games, they are enormous and powerful.
Threat in the city. Nest teams are on site and attempting to disarm. I repeat, we have a confirmed new. Everyone, hang on!
Coming in at number three on the list is a series that I've been playing quite a bit on stream recently, and that's Call of Duty. Call of Duty 1 originally came out in 2003 and was immediately a hit with fans. And ever since, every year or two, the Call of Duty franchise has released multiple different types of games, ranging all the way back in World War I to Vietnam, all the way to future combat situations with mechs and jumping in the air with jetpacks. The Call of Duty franchise, while it's not extremely versatile, has grown its legs out in recent years. And with recent game modes like Warzone, which harken back to games like Fortnite, Call of Duty isn't going anywhere anytime soon. And over these short few decades that they have been making games, they have managed to accumulate a massive amount of wealth and spread that across multiple studios across the world, making games around the clock.
Yeah, have you figured it out a little bit?
It's a lot simpler than I was making it.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, my tilts were insane, dude. Oh my gosh, this conversion's so
Next up, we have Mario. A game that you are all probably waiting and expecting to see on this list. Our number two spot is Nintendo's Golden Boy. Mario originally first came out in 1981 and has been coming out on every single Nintendo platform ever since. Mario has a range of different games, from Super Mario Galaxy to Super Mario 64, and originally was a side-scrolling adventure game where Mario would jump on top of Goombas and throw green shells. The series is beloved by almost all gamers across the world, and regardless of whether you're a mom with a 9-to-5 or a young child that has all day to play, Mario is a fun and engaging series that anyone could get into. And it's because of that that Mario has been able to garner so much financial success for the Nintendo platform and really become a staple of society across the world.
Try. So, you do have some.
And now, guys, finally, for the number one spot and biggest game franchise of all time, we have a franchise that blows all others out of the water when we talk about gross income. And that's Pokemon. Originally coming out in 1996, around the time I was born, Pokemon is far and away the biggest gaming franchise in the world. Starting with Pokemon Red and Blue, Black and White, and other franchises, the series has now evolved into alternate reality like Pokemon Go, and new games coming out as well. But one thing has stayed tried and true throughout the entire time Pokemon has been alive, and that is it is one of the most popular games in all existence. Every single Pokemon game that has released has topped the bestseller charts, and it shows with the massive amount of money that Nintendo has made from this. Those are the 10 biggest gaming franchises of all time to date. And it will be interesting to see 10 years from now, 20 years from now, where all these games are on the list. Because as we progress as a society and gaming becomes more and more mainstream, games like Pokemon and Mario making tens and tens of billions of dollars is going to become the norm. And it will be great to see the newer games like Fortnite continue to shine and make more and more money, and to see where all these franchises truly wind up. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed my top 10. Let me know what you guys want to see next, if there's any other top 10s about my personal views on gaming, my favorite games, what studios I think are the best studios of all time. Let me know down below what you guys want to see. And if you want to talk with me live about my thoughts on gaming as a whole and really the entire gaming landscape, check out twitch.tv/franklygaming, where I would love to talk with everybody watching this video and see your thoughts as well. But thank you guys very much. I will see you in the next video.